Ladies and gentlemen, Roblin Circus brings you the dynamic, the spectacular, the colossal debut of Mademoiselle K. Rogers, the beautiful, superb, divine, new protege of the renowned Flying Devil. I say, watch her there. Look out. Swinging like a human pendulum on the great rock of eternity, daring her doom, thwarting her future, deriding her destiny, just to thrill you folks. In fact, she's the queen of them all.
Shout a little louder, Gabby.
What for?
Maybe you'll convince the Flying Devils that I'm good enough to be a part of their act.
If Jerome and McAvoy don't think so, they're a couple of chumps.
Don't, Jess, please.
Well, I hope you heard that, Mr. Jerome. I'm a finished product, according to Mr. Roblin himself.
Now, he's the boss of the show, but not the boss of the act. Come on, get up there and go to work.
Oh, Charlie, please let me go on with you and Bob tonight, just to prove that I'm ready with everything you've taught me.
I'll be the one to decide when you're ready. Oh. Come on, get up there. We'll try one together.
Jess, I wish you wouldn't keep encouraging Kay like that.
Why not? She's a great little trooper. Your dad would be proud if he could see her today.
That's where you're wrong. Pop never wanted Kay to be a circus performer.
Yeah, and old Joe Muscle up there knows that, too. Look at him. Why, he's gotten so inflated since he's been running the act that he can take off without a trapeze.
Charlie's all right. He's a swell showman. Without his brains, we wouldn't have reached first base after Pop died.
It's that same smart head of his that realizes you could no more keep Kay off a trapeze than you could stop Gabby from talking. Well, I like that.
Hi, everybody.
Oh, Gloria.
Old Limber Lily herself. How's toots?
Stiff as a starched shirt. Caught a little cold, I guess. Oh, gosh.
That's what you get for stepping out with those local yokels.
You'd better get that chassis limbered up before the sideshow opens. Say, where's Slippery? Have you seen him, Gloria?
It's over in the dressing tent.
Hold still, I'll vaccinate you with this needle. Ow! Come back here.
But that's me.
You've got more wiggle in your system than a hula dancer.
Carlotta, what do you do with a woman after 35 years of the same harness?
30.
I try to be a man, Slippery, and stick up for my rights. After all, that's a husband's privilege.
I'd like to see him try it.
Molly, will you sew the tassel on my boot? Dynamite got sassy last night and pawed it off.
Then I'll do it, Molly. Thanks.
Say, that tiger's gonna pull more than a tassel off of her one of these days.
Still, will you? Or I'll stab you between the matinee and night show.
If you do, I'll charge you admission. Kiss me.
Please let me
go. Not until you promise to marry me right away. Today.
Oh, darling, I want a real wedding with flowers.
What will be so much more fun to elope? We'll keep it a secret until we start on our vaudeville dates.
All right, darling. Anything you say.
Too bad she fell for the wrong guy, ain't it?
Yeah.
Huh? You're crazy.
Think so? Say, if I was in love with a girl, I wouldn't let me swell-headed partner of mine shove me out of the picture with a lot of phony glamour.
And do those green little schoolgirls go for that flashy stuff?
You two are crazy. As far as Kay is concerned, I'm not even in the picture.
In that case, why don't you turn on the personality, honey, and give that sidekick of yours a fair run for his money?
Kay hasn't anything on her mind but a career.
Well, Joe Muscle up there ain't working on that theory. Ain't that right, Sugar? Well, where are you? Listen, Pretzel. One fine day, you're going to forget the combination and be stuck like that the rest of your life.
Up there. Get up there, Dynamite. Come here. Come here. Up, up. Back there, Dynamite. Get back.
Come over here. Come here. Come here. Well, you won't do it, Mom.
Kid, that was darn close.
Tabby, get Doc Mason at once.
Yeah, okay.
Out of here, all of you. Go on.
Take it easy, Carlotta. You know, you should have gotten rid of that cat a long time ago. He's a bad actor.
Hey, would you lie down?
I'm all right. You can't blame Dynamite. I had it coming to me. Guess it went kind of haywire when I saw Charlie and Kay. Anyhow, thanks. But don't do a crazy stunt like that again. You're too nice a kid to risk your neck on anybody.
Oh, forget it. I just...
Hello, Carlotta.
Hello, Doc.
Carlotta, what happened? Is it bad, Doc?
Not bad enough to put me out of the picture.
You're lucky it wasn't worse, Carlotta.
Bob, there must be something I can do for Carlotta.
No, honey, she's okay. Dr. Mason's with her now.
Are you sure?
Oh, of course. The only thing that's bothering her is that she'll be out of the show tonight.
Well, then I'll go in and get my
clothes.
Hold
on, let me do it. The last favor I'll be able to do you this season. Now, you run over to the wardrobe where you can make a change, and I'll get your duds.
But...
I'll see you in a jiffy. Okay, Doc?
Not bad. There's always danger of infection. We better get to a hospital right away for observation.
All right, all right.
Don't think you can fool me. You were making love to her. I know it. You can't do this to me. I won't let you.
Now stop acting like a jealous school kid. You're upset, honey. Here. Look at me.
I'm sorry to barge in on you like this. I came after Kay's clothes.
I'm sorry for being such a fool. It's silly to think of your going for a kid like Kay.
No!
You're forgetting that arm. Doc said he'd have the car around in a few minutes.
You will come to the hospital between shows tonight.
Try and keep me away.
Hello there, Shorty. You have this for class.
A knockout. On a clear day, they'll be able to see you from Mars.
You know, I had to drag out my number one wardrobe for the farewell dinner.
Gee, I hate to see this show break up. It's been happy times in Dixie with this troupe.
Ain't it the truth? You know, when I sing Old Ag Zion at the banquet, I'm really gonna mean it.
Say, Molly, where is that hospital where they took Carlotta?
The West Side Hospital. 3 blocks over that way and turn to the right.
Thanks.
Hurry up, everybody. The bus is waiting.
Well, you look mighty happy, kitten. What's on your mind?
Secret. All my own.
Well. Come on, Papa. Let's get going.
Well, my two precious godfathers, I'm ready.
Now, look, honey, you better go on with the gang. Well, I've got to see an agent about our water bill dates for the winter.
And miss all the fun? Oh, darling, you just...
Well, business is business, honey. Anyway, I'll try not to be too late and get there before the party's over.
Well, all right. But you will hurry.
Sure. I'll see you later.
So long.
Ready, Bob?
Mm-hmm.
Come in, Gabby.
Right out in front. I ain't had any expensive coffee spill on this vest in over a year. Come on, truck on down, babe. Here we go.
Are you sure you don't want to dance?
No, I'd rather sit here and talk to you. Just imagine, Bob. Pretty soon I'm really going to belong to all this.
Honey, why don't you forget the circus, like Pop wanted you to?
Oh, you're not going into that again.
Well, you...
I know. You're afraid for me just like Father was. That's why he tucked me away in that convent. But don't you see, Bob? All the convents in the world couldn't change me. I'm Pop Rogers' daughter. This was his world. And it's mine.
Yes, I can see that. But I'd rather see you living a normal life, with a real home. Not one that can be shifted around like a tent.
Well, how can I live in a real home when... Oh, Bob, I've just got to tell you, I can't keep it another moment. Charlie and I were married this morning.
Mary?
Oh, Bob, I... Happy about it?
Well, yes, of course, honey. Charlie's a grand guy. He's the best in the world. You know what I think of you.
Thanks, Bob. You know, you're a pretty grand guy yourself. You'll always be to us.
I may be getting old, son, but I can still knock those kids right off of the seats.
Yeah.
Is Charlie in yet?
No.
Holy smokes! Say, you guys are on in a minute. You want me to tell Jess to make the switch?
No, no, he'll be here all right.
Okay, by me. Pardon you?
What's on?
Well, according to the band, it's number 4.
On next, huh? Give me a lift with my shoes, will you? It's the darndest town to try to find a taxi cab when you want one.
I had to finally do a 3.5 block sprint in about 2 minutes flat.
Yeah? How's Carlotta?
Oh, she's all right. Chafing at the bit a little, because they're holding her there.
I had the devil of a time getting away from her.
Yeah, you must have had. Disappoint your wife as you did.
So Kay told you, eh? I suppose you told her I was with Carlotta.
I did not.
But I'm telling you this. That
listen, you mugs. That's your whistle. You're on now.
All right, go ahead. Spill it. What are you going
to
tell me?
Just this. Kay's in love with you, but she doesn't think she's married to a two-timing egotistical heel. And if you don't see that she's right from here out...
Oh, yeah?
Why, you big get-up! Why, it's split wide open. I ought to pin his ears down.
Adhesive, quick.
Why, you can't go on with that.
I've got to.
Oh, nothing, lady. He just tripped on a new tent with him. He wasn't expecting one on the way out.
You sure he's all right?
Just a scratch.
Have you ever seen anyone like him?
No. I've been lucky so far.
Ready?
Why don't they let us know?
Please, dear.
Kay, I couldn't help it. It was an accident. You believe me, don't you?
Well, how can anybody blame you? It wouldn't have happened if you...
Shut up!
Bob, of course it was an accident. I believe that. I always will. And so will Charlie.
Thanks, Bob. Thanks.
He has a badly broken shoulder that will mend nicely, but I'm afraid his career as a trapeze performer is ended.
I'll go in and talk with him first, Bob. Then I'm sure he'll want to see you.
Kay.
Oh, my dear.
I'm a fine husband for you now.
The finest in the world. You're going to be all right, darling. The doctor said so.
Sure I am. Why, they couldn't kill me if they dropped me off the top of the Rocky Mountains.
Of course not. Why, in a few weeks, you'll be on your feet as good as new again.
You're not sorry you married me?
Oh, I'm glad.
Don't worry, honey. I'll be tops again in no time.
I know you will, darling. But, Charlie, Bob's outside. I'm going to ask him to come in. Bob.
Charlie, I...
You didn't manage to wipe me out quite as completely as you expected, did you?
Oh, darling, you don't know what you're saying.
Oh, yes, I do. He's in love with you. He always has been. He learned that we were married and he dropped me tonight deliberately.
Oh, darling, that isn't true. Please understand, it was just an accident.
Hi, Carlotta. Hey, nice joint you got here, ain't it, honey? Come here, I got some talk for you.
Oh, I thought everybody deserted me.
Say, listen, sweet, you gotta help me out. You know, Charlie thinks that Bob dropped you in deliberately tonight.
What do you mean? Charlie's hurt?
Well, hasn't anybody told you what happened?
No.
Well, Charlie fell and they brought him here right after the accident.
Where is he?
Well, down the hall there in 324.
324?
Yeah.
Oh.
Hey, Carlotta, come here. You can't go in there now, honey.
Oh, Charlie, darling. Why didn't they tell me? Why didn't you send for me?
Oh, don't worry about me. I'm all right. I can take a fall with the best of them.
Oh, my darling.
Oh, Kay. Do you mind if I have a minute alone with Carlotta?
Of course not.
Why should she mind?
Kay and I were married this morning.
You were married?
Now, wait a minute. I can explain.
Yes, you're good at that. You've explained away girls in every burg we've played. And I've listened to you and tried to laugh it off. But I've never been asked to swallow a marriage before. That's going to be a little tough for you to talk yourself out of.
No, Carlotta, don't take it like that.
How should I take it? With a song in my heart and a bless your children? And then run away and have a good cry in front of your picture? Oh, no. This is Carlotta you're talking to, not some hysterical shop girl. And so you are married, and this is your bride. Well, here's where I get a load off my chest and tell her just what a prize package she got.
I didn't understand about you and Charlie, or I would have told you before how we felt. I'm sorry.
There's just one question I want to ask you. Do you love him?
Yes.
Well, that's one thing you've got in common. You both love Charlie.
Honey, well, you've got to listen to me. I didn't know she felt like that. Well, you know she's just jealous. You're the only woman in the world for me. I'm going to need you, honey. I'm going to come back and we're going to do great things together.
Of course. You and I together. It's funny. I spent half my life trying to get under the big top and now I have to leave it.
Come, come, Kay. Cheer up. Why, shucks, maybe those doctors are all wrong.
Besides, Charlie thinks Bob dropped him deliberately.
Oh, that's nonsense. He'll get over that.
Well, what about Bob?
Now, don't you start worrying about him. I've talked him into going along with us to winter quarters.
Well, I guess it's goodbye. This last year has been the happiest one in my life.
And it's going to be that way again. Why, in a couple of months, you and Charlie will show me a trapeze routine that'll knock the spots off anything in the show business.
Thanks, Jess.
Thanks for everything.
You mind leaving us alone, Jess?
Of course not. Carlotta?
Goodbye, youngster. And take care of yourself.
I didn't want you to go without knowing that I... Well, I feel like a heel for that scene tonight. There wasn't any excuse for it except... Well, I guess a jealous woman is dynamite.
I understand perfectly, Carlotta.
Just because I couldn't hold him, there's no reason that he doesn't love you. He married you. That's the answer. And it's going to work out swell. You're all he needs, honey. I'd only hurt him.
I want to make him well. That's all I care about. And it'll help a lot to know that we can be friends. Always.
Well, I guess that's my cue for an exit. Goodbye. And all the luck in the world.
Bye.
Missed you.
Oh, Bob, I'm afraid. I feel like the world, like everything is leaving me.
Hey, fella. How about that chin? Don't you know the weatherman said no rain today? Hmm?
Did he?
Uh-huh.
All aboard!
Bob, it was all a terrible mistake tonight. Charlie didn't mean what he said. He couldn't have. He'll realize he was wrong when he's feeling better, when he's had time to think.
Sure he will.
Goodbye, Bob. Someday the right one's going to tell you you're the grandest person in the world.
I'll take it from you until she comes along.
Fine act, Stefano. There's only one thing missing.
What's that?
You need another fellow to give it the punch to the finale.
What, Rublin?
Just the right boy for you. A sock performer, a great kid personally, and what's more, a real name.
Yeah?
One of the flying devils, Bob McAvoy.
McAvoy? Nothing doing.
Now, what's the matter with you? He's the best in his line.
Look, Rublin, I know McAvoy's in a tough spot. But those are my own kids up there. I can't take a chance with their lives.
Now, Stefano.
Oh, I'm sorry, Mr. Roebling.
Ah, they're just a bunch of small-timers. Been doing the same act for years. Why, they haven't even sense enough.
Yeah, I know. Well, thanks for trying again, but it's no use. You have an accident in this game, you're poison to everybody. Well, I guess I'll mosey on east and see if I can get a vaudeville date for a single.
You're gonna stay right here. You ought to be ashamed of yourself getting discouraged. Why, it's only December. We still got 2 months to get another partner for you. We're gonna break that jinx or bust.
Okay, I'm staying.
That's the spirit. And, oh, by the way, do you want to do a favor for Molly and Slippery?
Sure, what is it?
I bought a Christmas tree for them. It's over there in the prop room. Trimmings and everything. Take them over there for me, will you?
Okay, Jess.
Hello? Sure, put her on. Kids, the surprise is Kay. I called her long distance and here she is.
Hello. Merry Christmas.
Molly, all the same to you. Gosh, it's good to hear your voice.
Hello, kittens.
Yes.
Yeah, this is Gabby. Hi, sugar.
How's about a hello for Gloria?
Just the menagerie going crazy. Gee, we missed you, honey.
And I've missed you. All of you. Your letters have meant so much to me, Molly.
Well, you just keep that chin up, honey. Who? Bob? Sure he's here. Hold the phone.
Say, Ted.
When are you going to break down and make a personal appearance?
Come on, Bob. She's asking for you especially.
Oh, let me say hello. Hiya, honey. This is Gloria, the twister.
Merry Christmas. This is the...
Give it to him. Come on, all of you. Help me, Mr. Smith.
Hello, fella. Merry Christmas.
Hello, Bob. Oh, it's so good to talk to you.
Same here, fella. Say, how about Charlie? I hear he's up and around, but... does he know?
Yes, he's known for a month that he'll never work in the air again. Oh, Bob, it's been so hard for him. Still bitter, but I'm confident he'll get over it. Yes, we've got to do something soon.
I want to go to work, find a partner. And Charlie, with his showmanship and training ability, can manage us, build us into a great team. What do you think of it, Bob?
Well, I guess it'd be okay, fella. I
hope you'd see it that way. Maybe I'll see you sooner than you expect. Goodbye, Bob. Give my love to everyone. Charlie.
I overheard everything you said. If it'll make you happy, I think it's a swell idea.
You mean you'll agree to it?
Yes. And, Bob, did he say that he'd do it?
Bob? I know.
You know, I've had time to do a lot of thinking. I was wrong about Bob. I realize now that it was an accident. I think if you went out to California first, you might be able to convince Bob that, well, that I've been acting like a fool, and I know it.
Oh, Charlie, you couldn't have said anything to make me any happier. Why, this is the most wonderful Christmas present I've ever had.
It's been two whole months.
Well, that's an awfully long time when you're away from everything you care about.
How'd you leave Charlie? Is he okay?
No, he's fine. Splendid. He doesn't blame you anymore. That's why he sent me on ahead to tell you.
Gee, that's the best news you could have brought me.
I knew that.
Come on, tell me everything on the way.
And Charlie will manage us. But don't you see, Bob, what it will mean to us? You will do it.
Well, if I don't, you'll find another partner and go on just the same, won't you?
Yes.
Okay, fella, but it'll make you happy.
Oh, thanks. I knew you would. Gosh, Bob, it'll be just like old times again.
Uh-huh. And tomorrow, young lady, begins the work. I have a couple of new stunts to show you that'll make you think you're sailing to the moon.
Those two kids up there certainly have the makings of a hit team.
You betcha.
Gosh, how those people can fly.
That's a marvelous routine. Charlie will be thrilled when he arrives.
Hello there, sweetheart.
Charlie! Darling, we didn't expect you so soon.
Oh, I wanted to surprise you.
Gosh, it's good to see you. Kay was right. You do look swell.
Thanks, Ken. I'm practically a new man in a lot of ways.
Oh, gosh, isn't it grand to be together again? Just we three.
I thought that last trick of yours. Oh, that was just practice routine. We're counting on you for the real stunt. We want you to work out a routine that'll make you proud to manage it.
What I have in mind is a little dangerous. You game?
You can't make it too tough for me. Whatever you say goes. You're the boss from now on, Charlie. Right, Kay?
Right, Simon Legree. What's your first command?
Upstairs, both of you.
Okay.
Hey, Charlie, about that dangerous business, lay it on my side, will you?
Oh, sure, I know. It'll take her a couple of seasons to wear off the green. Go on, get up there.
Right.
Okay, that's swell. That'll pull them in. Now, you fellas get busy. Plaster every stand between Kansas City and Philadelphia. Now, go ahead and step on it. But we open the first of next month.
Hey! Open this door, somebody! Hey! Oh, girls, step on it. Or we'll never have these land rags done for the opening show.
Pretty wild, aren't they?
Oh, hello. Yeah, the toughest I've ever seen. Gee, I'd like the job of training them.
Same old Carlotta.
Yeah, but not the same old Charlie. I'm proud the way you've come through for Kay and Bob.
Thanks. You've been swell.
Go away, Kitty.
That's the closest I ever come to being a hamburger. Look at here. Look at the pants. $25.
Which proves they're no playmates for you, young fella.
You're not going to train those things, are you, Carlotta?
Nah, just won't let me. He just bought them for exhibition.
What a terrific sight they make. All in one cage.
All in one cage. Thanks, Gabby.
I wonder what's eating that guy.
Bob?
Yeah?
I've got it. The greatest idea for a finale that's ever been conceived. Listen, you hear that racket?
Yeah?
Those are the new lions Jesse bought. Boy, what an idea. I can see it now. A bunch of ferocious, untamed lions prowling around in a cage. An open-top cage under your trapeze act. Think of the audience sitting on the edges of their seats watching you fly over some of the wildest animals that ever came out of Africa.
Charlie, you're not serious. You can't mean...
Oh, wait a minute, Kay. It's a knockout. It's great. But, Charlie, you can't let Kay take a chance like that.
I'm not planning to use Kay. I'm going to put this grand finale right in your lap as a single.
Grand finale. Charlie, it's immense. It'll be the hit of the show.
No, Bob, you can't. You might fall. They'd tear you to pieces. Charlie, please don't ask Bob to do it.
Kay, you're letting your imagination run away with you. Don't forget, fella, you're in the show business.
But, Bob...
Oh, nothing can happen. Especially when I'm... up there on my own.
It'll be a cinch. We'll make this the top circus act of the year.
Sure, it's great.
Charlie, it's suicide.
Yeah, that's an idea. That's what we'll call it. The suicide act. And we'll tell it to the world.
only got 10 minutes to inspect that rigging.
Oh, yeah. Ready, Stephen?
Looks okay to me, Charlie, but I'd feel better if you'd inspect that special trapeze.
Okay.
That sent Daniel into the lines didn't get nothing on that guy.
Yeah, he sent his own brother into slaughter just to give his public a thrill.
Time to crack up. Bob knows what he's doing. This is your first big test, honey, as a real trooper. And you can't let him down now.
I won't.
That's good.
Suicide act is right. The only thing Charlie missed is an engraved invitation to the undertaker.
You shut up and get out of here.
All right, all right.
How he can be as cool as a cucumber is more than I can understand.
I'll pick mine on a horse any day.
Pipe down. Pipe down. You heard Jess give orders about everybody keeping cheerful.
Please don't push back there. You must stay in and take a line.
Yep, all set.
Good.
I better get Kay then.
What is he going to do with that prop man's uniform?
He's going to work under the axe.
Come on.
Good luck, kid.
Knock him right off the seat, fella.
Take it easy, Bob. And good luck.
Hey, is Kay all right?
Sure. Here they come now.
I'm afraid, Bob.
Here now, fella. What'd I tell you about that chin?
Let's go.
Good luck, kid.
Good luck, kid.
Good luck, folks.
Come on, folks. Just squint and look 'em over.
Guess they bring them on later.
Mama, are the lines going to get the lady, too?
No, dear, of course not. Just the man. Look.
Thank you.
What a sight.
Sure glad it's him, not me.
Thanks, Charlie.
Can't get him out. My shoulder. I can't make it. I'm going to drop you.
St. Louis on the 3rd of May.
Don't worry, Jess, we'll be there. And in the meantime, don't let Carlotta tame those lions. We're going to make the act the biggest attraction in your show.
Now remember, kids, when you get to Niagara Falls, no stunt.
So long, Gabby.
So long, kids.
Thank you.